Teresa Santa from iBrand Your Business. I'm going to show you how to design your Facebook app icon. Your app icons are these little icons that you see across the top here, right below your timeline cover photo. And while I'm at it, I can also give you some other quick tips on how to create your thumbnail using free tools on the internet. And first, I want to explain that Facebook comes with preloaded apps such as your photos, the like count app, and unfortunately, those cannot be changed. So a rule of thumb is that you'll know if they can be changed if you click this little down arrow right here. First of all, you have to be an admin or a manager of your page before you see this. If not, you need to have that change. But once you click the little down arrow, you'll see that there's a little icon in the very corner that it has a little pencil. If you click on it, you're going to see where it says edit settings. If you don't see edit settings, for example, if I go to the maps and I click that, you don't see that there. That means you cannot change this icon. So I'm going to go ahead and click here back on this one because I know it is changeable. Click on edit settings and then you'll see custom tab image. You can change it. Okay. So before we go to all of that trouble in doing that, let's go ahead and start designing our little icon. We're going to be doing it on our fictitious business page of Dreamy Shoes. And we're going to be editing this icon right here. So let's go ahead and get started. What this is going to end up looking like is like this. I've already started on one over here. Let me make this bigger so you could see. But it's just going to say free newsletter. And I'm going to make it a little bit smaller because it's really that small. So while I'm designing, I will add the little plus sign so you can see it better. Okay, so we're going to be using a free online tool called PicMonkey, PicMonkey.com. And we're going to be hovering over this design icon here, clicking on custom. And the custom size for those apps is 111 pixels by 74 pixels. So let's go ahead and type that in. Whoops. And that's the exact same. Those are the exact dimensions you have for Facebook or else you're going to get an error. So if we go a little bit over because we use an edge or something like that, I'm going to show you how to fix that too. So click on do it. Okay. So let's go ahead and just get started on our design. My background color that I'm using, if you go to basic edits, you'll see canvas color. And I'll go ahead and change this color to whatever color, use whatever color you'd like. But I have my color here. And if not, you can use this little area here. Okay, so I know it's this color. I'm going to make it a lot larger so we can see it. So I'll go ahead and add that there. And then I'm going to go ahead and also add this little cool effect. It's in the textures. Click apply to apply your canvas color. And see, if you see this little icon with the crown, that means that that's a paid item. You have to pay for it or be a PicMonkey member. But everything we're doing is going to be for free, so we're not going to be using any of those. So the next thing I'm going to use is this little space thing here, and I like this one because it gives it a nice glow in the background when we add our text. So I'll click on that. I'll click apply. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start adding my text. So I'm going to click on the text icon. I'm going to use this Poetson one. Click on add text. I'm going to hover my little text box. I'll move this out of the way so I can have room. I'm going to change this to white. And I'll go ahead and start typing in here. And I'm going to type in the word free. And then you can also change the size either here by clicking, by highlighting and clicking and making it larger. And if this happens here, what you could do is just click on the side here. You'll see this edge turn into like a triple edged side here. So you can make this a little larger. I usually just kind of do that. And then I can go back over here and make my text bigger. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and move this over here. And then the next thing we want to put in is the word newsletter. So let's go ahead and do that over here. and newsletter. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and highlight the newsletter here, and first of all, I'm gonna change this font, change the color to white, make my size bigger. Let me change this here. I'm gonna scroll this all the way over so I can go ahead and highlight my newsletter and make the size as large as I need it to be. You can also click on the corners here and enlarge your font size this way. So that's looking pretty good. And then I have a little icon here, so I'm going to show you another really cool thing that you can do. I use overlays a lot. Click on the little butterfly icon over here, and you can do a lot of different overlays. For example, there's really cool little things that you could do if you wanted like a happy face. Let me click away from here. And if you don't see it, the reason I don't see what I just clicked on right now is because this is so big. I'm doing it for the tutorial, but if you go small, you'll see it over here on the side. And then here's my smiley face. But I'm not going to use a smiley face. I'm going to have my own icon, but I just wanted to show you that. Go ahead and delete that. Make this large again so you can see. I have my own icon, so I'm going to go up and scroll up here and click on my own. And I will select my icon from my computer, from my desktop, and click on open. And again, I can't see it, so I'm going to make this smaller. It's way up here. Okay. I'm going to make this a little bit larger. Okay, that looks pretty good. And then the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a border. So I'm going to add a red border to this icon. So the way I do that is I'm going to click on frames. And you know, before I go to frames, I want to show you something. Let's say you wanted this icon to be in the very back of this F. If you right click on the icon, you can actually bring that all the way or send it to the back and it'll be behind the F. Okay, it's a little trick. Wanted to show you that. But in this case, I don't want that. So I'm going to just move it over here. But I want to bring it back to the front. You right click, you bring to front, and now it's in the front of the F. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and set that there. All right, so let's go and add that border that I was talking to you about. Let's go over here to these icons on the left and click on frames. And I'm going to add a simple icon, or I'm sorry, a simple edge. I don't want an outer color, so I'm going to set this to 0. And I want my inner color to be red. Okay, and I want the thickness to be about 2. So I'm going to go ahead and make this as small as my icon really is, just to see what it looks like and make sure that I don't need to be moving anything else around. If it looks good to me, great. I'm just going to go ahead and leave it that way. And here's a little trick. Click back on your basic edits. Oh, and you need to apply the edge, of course. Sorry. Click back at your basic edits when you've done that and click on resize. And you're going to see that this changed to 115 by 78. Well, the reason that happened is because we added that red edge. And in PicMonkey, that makes your canvas larger, and we don't want that because Facebook will give you an error. So we're going to change this size back. I'm going to uncheck key proportions, and I am going to change this back to 111 by 74. Okay, because that's the exact size I need for Facebook. So once I'm done with that, I'm going to go ahead and click on save. I'm going to save it to my computer. I'm going to call it, I don't know. I think I already have one here. Free newsletter icon, right? Let's say yes, save it. And then I'm going to go into Facebook and go ahead and change this icon here. So again, you're going to click the down arrow on Facebook so you can get this little pencil icon. Click on that. Click on edit settings. You're going to custom tab image change. It's going to open up a new window. You're going to click on edit. You're going to click on choose file. and go ahead and choose on the file that you have on there or that you saved. Okay, so now you see the image, it's there. So there's no real save or anything like that. Once you've done that, all you gotta do is click on the X here, go back to, it'll go back to the Facebook, and then you can give it a custom name or what have you. Let's just say sign up. And then click save here, click OK. Once you click OK, you're gonna see the icon change. Okay, so that's how you do that. Let me give you one other quick tip on, I told you I was gonna give you a quick tip on this thumbnail here. So I'm just gonna go back to PicMonkey. Weirdest name in the world, huh? It's like pickyournose.com or something. Okay, so if you hover over design, you can actually get that square template that they already have here for you to do your thumbnail, or you can click on custom, put the minimum dimensions that Facebook requires for your thumbnail, which is 180 by 180 pixels. Whoops, and then click on the button. And there's your square. And you can just start designing away, put in a canvas color or do an overlay of a picture of your logo. There's just so much that you can do. Just like when we did the other icon, that you can just have some fun with it, you know. I'm just going to add just this cute little guy saying coming soon. And that's about it, guys. I just wanted to show you that very quickly. Have fun doing this. And please subscribe if this tutorial has helped you. And thank you so much for watching. We'll see you soon. Okay, bye.